We shall commence this module by discussing the profit maximization. In recent years, behavioral approach to the theory of firm have been developed, which also relaxes the assumption of profit maximization. According to the behavioral theory, firms do not tend to maximize neither profits nor sales and nor utility. A distinctive feature of the behavioral approach is that it considers how the firms actually behave, or in other words, how firms take their decisions in the real world. These decisions of the firms relate to the price of its product, level of output, sales strategy, growth maximization, etc. The advocated of the behavioral approach challenge the assumption of profit maximization and also the omission of the uncertainty from the conventional theory of the firm. Under conditions of uncertainty about demand and cost conditions, it is not possible to judge whether the profit is maximized or not, as the information regarding the profits is not there. According to Cohen and Seart, the two authors of the behavioral theory of the firm, in particular, as one looks closely at the behavior of the actual firms, the justification for the assumption of profit maximization seems to weaken. When one adds uncertainty to the firm's decision making process, even defining the meaning of profit maximization becomes difficult to do in an empirically meaningful way. The behavioral theory of the firm takes the position that arguments over motivation are somewhat fruitless. The critical issue is not whether one assumes profit maximizing instead of satisfying behavior. Instead, it is fruitless to develop an understanding of the process of decision making within the firm. H. A. Simon, one of the advocates of the behavioral approach to the theory of firms, points out that firms aims at satisficing rather than profit maximization. That is, firms wants to achieve satisfactory level of profits. According to him, there is an aspiration level that a firm has. An aspiration level of a firm is based on its goals as well as its past experience. If the firm believes that its actual performance is sufficient enough to the aspiration level, then it will be revised upward. On the other hand, if the firm believes that its actual performance is not sufficient enough to achieve a given aspiration level, then the aspiration level will be lowered down. Seart and March have put forth a full-scale behavioral theory of the firm. In a modern large multi-product firm, ownership is separate from management. This is basically the principal agent problem. It explains the relationship between the principal, that is the owner, and the agent, that is the person who performs the owner's work. The principal agent shows that whenever the difference between ownership and control exists, then the self-interest of agent makes profits lower than in a situation where principals act as their own agents. Here the firm is not considered as a single entity with a single goal of profit maximization. According to Seart and March, modern business firm are group of individuals who are engaged in the decision making process relating to its internal structure. These business firms have multiple goals. After studying this module, you shall be able to know the concept of behavioral theory of firm, understand why the behavioral theorist advocates relax the profit maximization assumption, know the principal agent theory, understand the organizational goals. Let us now begin understanding the Syed-Marsh behavioral theory. The behavioral theory of the firm as developed by Syed and March focuses on the decision making process of the large multi-product firm under the uncertainty in an imperfect market. In a modern large multi-product firm, ownership is separate from the management. This is basically the principal agent problem. It explains the relationship between the principal, that is the owner, and the agent, that is the person who performs the owner's work. The principal agent shows that whenever the difference between ownership and control exists, then the self-interest of agents makes the profits lower than in a situation where the principals act as their own agent. Here the firm is not considered as a single entity with a single goal of profit maximization. According to Syed and Mark, modern business firms are a group of individuals who are engaged in decision making process relating to its internal structure whose interest may conflict with each other. They call this complex organization as organizational coalition. This organizational coalition may include managers, workers, stockholders, customers, and so on. These business firms have multiple goals. Syed and March deals not only with the internal structure of the firm, but also with the problem of uncertainty. They challenge the assumption of profit maximization and also the omission of the uncertainty from the conventional theory of the firm. Under conditions of uncertainty about demand and cost conditions, it is not possible to judge whether the profit is maximized or not, as the information regarding the profits is not there. Unlike the conventional traditional theory of the firm, which was based on single goal of profit maximization, the behavioral theory assumes that an organization has multiple goals to achieve. According to Syed and March, an organization has 5 goals which the firms generally possesses. These are 1. Production goal, 2. Inventory goal, 3. Sales goal, 4th. Share of the market goal, and 5th. Profit goal. Production goal. There are certain goals that are needed to be achieved at the production level. This goal originates from the production department. It is the main objective of the production manager to smoothen the production process. This is possible by managers by distributing production evenly over time, irrespective of the fluctuations in the demand that is possible seasonally. He is also avoiding excess capacity, laying off the workers at some periods, overworking the plant, and resorting to rush the recruitment of workers at other times because of the consequence of higher cost, excess capacity, dismissal payment, or to the frequent breakdowns of machinery and waste of raw materials in period of rush production. This goal is related to output decisions. Second, inventory goals. The inventory goal originates mainly from the inventory department. If such a department exists, or from the sales and production departments. This goal represents the demands of coalition members who are well connected with the inventories. It is affected by the pressures on the inventory from the customers and salesmen. This goal is related to the decision in output and sales areas. Third, sales goal. The sales goal aims at meeting the demand of coalition members connected with sales who regard the sales necessary for the stability of the organization. The sales department wants an adequate stock of output for the customers. The sales goal originates from the sales department. Fourth, share of the market goal. The market share goal is an alternative to the sales goal. It is related to the demands of sales management of the coalition who are primarily interested in comparative success of the organization and its growth. Like the sales goal, the market share goal is related to sales decision. The same department will also normally set the sales strategy, that is, decide on the advertising campaigns, the market research programs, and so on. Fifth, profit goal. The profit goal is set by the top management so as to satisfy the demands of shareholders and the expectations of the bankers and other finance institutions, and also to create funds with which they can accomplish their own goals and projects or satisfy the other goals of the firm. We have seen the five goals that an organization should possess. The number of goals can be increased, but this addition of new goals would result in complexity of decision-making process. There exists a negative relationship between efficiency of decision making and the number of goals. The efficiency of decision making decreases as the number of goals increases and vice versa. The goals of the firm are decided by the top management. This is done through continuous bargaining between the groups of coalition. The firms, while forming the goals, attempts to satisfy as many demands which it is confronted by various members of the coalition. Some of the goals that we have studied may be desirable to all the members of the coalition. For example, the sales goal is directly desirable to the sales manager and his department, to the top management, and most probably to the shareholders as well. But it is also indirectly desirable to all the other members of the coalition, as all the members of the coalition knows that unless the firm sells whatever it produces, no one will be able to attain his own individual goals. But except this goal, there are other goals that are desirable only to few members of the group. For example, profit goal is directly desirable to the shareholders and to the top management, but not of the employees in the lower administrative levels or of the workers on the floor. The goals of the firm, like the goals of individual members or group of coalition, take the form of aspiration levels rather than the strict maximizing constraint. The firm in the behavioral theories seeks to satisfy, that is, to attain a satisfactory overall performance as defined by the set aspiration goals rather than maximize profits, sales, or other magnitudes. The firm is a satisficing organization rather than a maximizing entrepreneur. Let us now talk about the conflicting goals. The goals of the firm, like the goals of the individual members or groups of the coalition, takes the form of aspiration levels rather than the strict maximizing constraints. The factors that determines these goals within the firm is the aspiration level of the individuals. These aspiration level changes over time as a result of the organizational learning. In the organizational coalition, these goals are regarded as the product of a bargaining learning process, but it is not necessary that different goals get resolved cordially. There may exist conflicts among the goals. The organizational coalition is thus a coalition of conflicting interest. These conflicting interest can be reconciled by the distribution of side payments among coalition members. The actual amount of side payment that needs to be distributed is not fixed for the coalition. That actual amount basically depends on the form of the coalition and demand of coalition members. In the long run, the demand for coalition members is equal to the side payments. The behavioral theory focuses on the short-run relation between side payment and demands. These side payments can be in the form of cash or in kind. The side payment in kind is mostly in the form of policy, that is, the right to take part in the policy decisions of the organization. In the short run, new demands are being constantly generated and the goals of the organizations are continuously adapted to take account of these increased demand. The demand for the coalition members in the organization need not to be mutually consistent. All this increased demand are not met simultaneously. The organization that is meeting the demand can remain viable by attending the demand in sequence. But the problem can still arise when the organization is not able to accommodate the demand of its coalition members even sequentially. This happens due to the lack of resources. Next, we will discuss about the satisficing behavior. We have seen above that conflicting goals of organization can be reconciled by the distribution of side payments among coalition members. Besides distribution of side payments, the conflicting goals of organization are resolved by subjecting them to a constant review. This constant review is required because aspiration levels of coalition members change with the experience. The aspiration levels change with the process of satisficing. Each person in the organization has a satisficing level for each of its goals. If this desired level is achieved, then they will not seek for more. But if this desired level is not achieved, the aspiration levels are revised downwards. If they are exceeding the desired amount, the aspiration levels are raised upwards. In both the situations, the satisfactory level of performance are changed accordingly. Organizational slack. A coalition is sound and workable if payments made to various members of the coalition are adequate. In order to have a workable coalition, enough resources are needed to meet all the demands of members of the coalition in an organization. This is generally not possible because there exists a disparity between the total resources available to the organization and the total payment required to maintain the coalition. According to Syed and March, the difference between the total resources available and total necessary payments is called organizational slack. The organizational slack arises in payments to the coalition members in the organization, that is, in excess of what is required to maintain the organization. There are other forms of slack exist when the organization operates under market conditions that are not perfect. There is a possibility that the shareholders may be paid dividends in excess of what is required to keep them in the organization, or the customers may be charged lower prices so that they may stick to the products of the firm. The workers may be paid wages in excess of what is needed to keep them in the firm. The executives may be provided with services and personal luxuries more than what is required to keep them. All such expenses in the form of excess payments are slack expenditures for the firm, which every member of coalition obtains from time to time. According to Syed and March, organizational slack is typically not zero, but it is positive. It is possible that some members of the coalition in general obtain a greater share of the slack than do the others. In general, those members of the coalition who are full time tend to get more payments than the other members of the coalition. This organizational slack is very important for the existence of coalition. The organizational slack plays a productive role by enabling the firm to maintain themselves under the crisis type situation. It also enables the firm to adjust itself to the changes in the external environment. It serves as the cushion to absorb the abnormal shocks. These payments increases during the boom period and decreases during the bad phases of business. Thus, organizational slack plays both a stabilizing and an adaptive role. Decision making process. The important parameter that need to be discussed is the decision making process. In the Syed-March model, the decision making rests with the top management and with the lower level of administration. It is the top management that sets the organizational goals and allocates the given resources to the various departments. This allocation of resources is based on their share of the total budget of the firm. The share in the budget depends upon the bargaining power and the skill of each manager. This bargaining power is determined by the past performance of each department and their hard work. In this process of allocation, the top management retains some funds to be allocated at its discretion at any time to any department. The decision making process at the lower level provides various degrees of freedom of action to the administration. In the budget, it is allocated to each department. Once the share is distributed from budget, each manager has considerable discretion in spending the funds at his disposal. All the decisions that are taken by the managers are implemented by the lower level staff based on their experiences and blueprint rules laid down earlier. Another factor that determines the decision making process is information and expectation formed within the organization. Information plays an important role in decision making process as it is required to facilitate the decision maker. Seeking information is not costless and it is required at each and every step. Search activity is started whenever problem persists, as search help to locate and collect the information. This information determines the aspiration of each department, which in turn helps the top management in setting up the goals. On the other hand, expectations also plays an important role in decision making process, as organizational expectations are related to the hopes and wishes of the decision maker. Given these two parameters that affect the decision making process, the top management examines and decides upon the projects presented by the managers. The top management evaluates the projects presented by the managers on the basis of two grounds. First, budget constraint, which emphasizes on the availability of funds for the project, and second is the improvement criteria, which focuses on whether the project is better than the existing one. In making decisions, the top management follows the rule that leads to a better state in the future than it was in the past. Thus, the Syed-Marsh model of behaviorism is thus an adaptive rational system. Let us now summarize what we have learnt in this module. The behavioral theory of firm, as developed by Syed and Marsh, focuses on the decision making process of the large multi-product firm under uncertainty in an imperfect market. In a modern large multi-product firm, ownership is separate from management. This is basically the principal agent problem. It explains the relationship between the principal and the agent. The principal agent shows that whenever the difference between ownership and control exists, then the self-interest of agent makes profit lower than in a situation where principals act as their own agents. Here, the firm is not considered as a single entity with a single goal of profit maximization. According to Syed and Marsh, modern business firms are a group of individuals who are engaged in the decision making process relating to its internal structure, whose interest may conflict with each other. They call this complex organization as the organizational coalition. This organizational coalition may include managers, workers, stockholders, customers, and so on. These business firms have multiple goals. Syed and Marsh deals not only with the internal structure of the firm, but also with the problem of uncertainty. They challenge the assumption of profit maximization and also the omission of uncertainty from the conventional theory of the firm. Under conditions of uncertainty about demand and cost conditions, it is not possible to judge whether the profit is maximized or not, as the information regarding profits is not there. Unlike the conventional traditional theory of the firm, which was based on single goal of profit maximization, the behavioral theory assumes that an organization has multiple goals to achieve, namely production goal, inventory goal, sales goal, market share goal, and the profit goal.